As the automotive industry hurtles into an electrified future, the competition between electric vehicles intensifies, and two titans stand at the forefront, the 2025 Porsche Macan and the 2025 Porsche Taycan. With sustainability becoming increasingly crucial and performance expectations soaring, consumers are eager to know which of these cutting-edge vehicles reigns supreme in terms of range, power, battery, and efficiency. A technical marvel with cutting-edge amenities and top-tier performance, the 2025 Porsche Macan has high expectations. A powerful competitor in the EV market, it will have 800-volt electrics for rapid 270kW charging. Concerns have been raised, however, about Macan's limited electric range. Digital spy photos of the instrument cluster indicated a dismal 145-mile range with 80% power left. The 2025 Porsche Macan is anticipated to be a performance monster. The exact performance specifications have yet to be revealed, but the current Macan models indicate what to expect. For example, the 2023 Porsche Macan S can go from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 4.7 seconds and has a top speed of 156 miles per hour. We can only anticipate enhanced functionality with the 2025 model's increased power and cutting-edge features. For Taycan, thanks to a new rear electric motor, an updated pulse inverter, and more powerful batteries, with updated thermal management and software, Taycan models are more powerful across the board. The base, rear-drive Taycan now makes 80 more horses than before, bumping its total output to 482 horsepower. But the Taycan Turbo S gets a massive bump, all the way to 938 horsepower from 750 horsepower and 818 lb-ft. The base Taycan will hit 60 miles per hour in 4.5 seconds, but the Turbo S will do the sprint in 2.3 seconds. That makes the Taycan Turbo S both the fastest and most powerful production Porsche in history. To get the full 938 horsepower, you'll need to use an F1-style push-to-pass steering wheel button, though. It doesn't deploy all 938 horses all the time. Now let's move to Macan. Commencing the day with a fully charged battery, the charging process, although unobserved, is anticipated to have taken around 20 minutes to boost the battery from 10 to 80% SOC, mirroring the Taycan, Porsche's other electrified vehicle sharing the same e-architecture as the Macan. The Taycan boasts a range ranging from the low to mid 200-mile range, a benchmark Porsche aimed to surpass with the all-electric Macan. The initial range estimate with a full battery was 304 miles. Upon reaching the midpoint of our journey, the crossover projected a 53% SOC upon arrival. Considering our conservative 70 miles per hour travel rate for the 250 miles, we estimate the Macan EV could have traveled approximately 290 miles before necessitating a recharge. A similarly equipped Macan EV, traveling at a slightly higher speed along the same route, concluded with an 11% SOC remaining on the battery. This estimation notably surpasses the Taycan and aligns the Macan EV with electric crossover SUVs like the Hyundai Ioniq 5, Ford Mustang Mach-E, Tesla Model Y, among others. And for Taycan, acceleration isn't the only thing that's faster, though. With that updated battery, the Taycan can now charge at 320 kilowatts, a 50 kilowatts boost in charge speed, and Porsche claims a 10 to 80% state of charge time of just 18 minutes. That's around half the time it would take for the 2024 Taycan, despite having a larger battery. Of course, such a short charge time requires perfect conditions, such as battery temperature, ambient temperature, and a capable DC fast charger. The battery is bigger, too. The optional Performance Battery Plus brings the battery capacity to 105 kWh, up from 93 kWh. While there aren't any official range United States EPA figures yet, Porsche claims the Taycan could get 365 miles of range during a test in California, under everyday conditions. The automaker has also published European WLTP-rated range figures for Taycan models, 421 miles for the base Taycan and 391 miles for the Taycan Turbo S. It's worth mentioning that WLTP data is always far more optimistic than our EPA figures. Now we look at efficiency that already proven by 2023 model. Porsche's official fuel economy number for the combined ADR 81/02 urban extra urban cycle for the Macan T is 9.5 L/100 km. The 2.0-liter 4-emitting 217 g/km of CO2 in the process. Over a week of city, suburban, and some freeway running, we saw a dash indicated average of 10.2 L/100 km. A solid, if unspectacular, result for a close to 1.9-ton SUV. Auto start-stop is standard, but pricey 98 RON premium unleaded is required, and you'll need 75 liters of it to fill the tank. Using the official number, that translates to a range of 789 kilometers, which drops to 750 kilometers using our real-world number. Taycan efficiency is something to look to. The GTS is fitted with the Performance Battery Plus as standard, which is a 93.4 kilowatt-hour battery pack that is an upgrade from the 79.2 kilowatt-hour battery that's standard in the Taycan 4S. Porsche claims the GTS has a greater driving range than the models around it, befitting its title as the sweet spot in the lineup. The company claims the GTS can go up to 485 kilometers between charges, compared to 414 kilometers for the 4S and 420 kilometers for the Turbo. Taycan GTS was able to do both an extended road drive and track running on a single charge, suggests the 485 kilometers claim is realistic. In terms of recharging times, Porsche quotes 9 hours using an AC 11 kilowatts outlet, while a DC 50 kilowatts charger can take it from 5% battery to 80% in 93 minutes. If you get access to the 350 kilowatts ultra rapid charger, it can top up 5 to 80% in just over 22 minutes. If you want to look at another review, click these videos.